Welcome back to the next session of Answers tutorial. I am going to solve the final problem of plane crust. We'll read the question first. For the plane crust shown in figure below, determine the displacement at nodes, determine the stresses in each bar, and verify the nodal equilibrium at node 1. This is the truss which is given. Here is the node 1 at which there is a load applied of 10 kN. At node 2, it is fixed, node 3 is fixed, node 4 is fixed. The length of the truss element between 1 and 4 is 12 meter. The length of truss element between node 1 and 2 is 12 meter. And between 1 and 3 is 12 root 2 meter, which is approximately 16.97 meters. For all the bars, the value of Young's modulus is given as 30 into 10 raised to 7 Pascal. And the cross-section area of each element is given as 0.02 meter square. Let's get started with answers now. I'll go to static structural and double click on it. I'll rename it as example 5. I'll first go to engineering data. I'll create a new material. I'll name it as material itself. I'll go to isotropic elasticity. The value of Young's modulus is given as 30 into 10 raised to 7 Pascal. And the value of Poisson's ratio I'll assume as 0.3. I'll go to project, update project. Next I'll go to geometry. I'll change the analysis type to 2D. Right click on geometry. New design modular geometry. I'll go to units, millimeter. XY, look at. I'll go to sketching. I'll first use the polyline. I'll draw two lines, right click, open end. Then I'll select a line. From this point, I'll draw another line. Now I'll go to dimensions. I'll give these dimensions. I'll choose the unit as meter, not millimeter. I'll take V1 as 12. H2 is given as 12. And L3 is 16.97. I'll click on look at. Next, I'll choose angle between these two lines. This value is 45. Now I'll go to concept, lines from sketches. I'll select sketch 1, apply, generate. I'll go to concept, cross section, rectangular. I'll choose the breadth as 0.2 and the height as 0.1. The product is 0.02 meter square as it is given in the question. Now I'll go to part 1, body 1. I'll choose the cross section as a rectangle. This completes my geometry. Next, I'll go to model and double click on it. I'll first go to geometry, line body. I'll change the material to the new material that I've created. I'll go to mesh. I'll change the sizing to fine, update. Next, I'll go to analysis settings. I'll choose vertex. This vertex is fixed. This vertex is also fixed. Fixed again. At this vertex, I'll insert force. I'll change vector to component. In the y direction, the force is, I'll just change the units to metric. It was in millimeter, I changed it to meter. I'll go to solution, right click, insert, deformation, directional along the x-axis for the entire body. Right click, insert, deformation, directional along the y-axis for the entire body. Right click, insert, deformation directional I want to calculate for this node, as it is asked to calculate the equilibrium there. Right click, insert, deformation, directional, along y-axis at this node. Right click, insert, probe, force reaction at the fixed end 1. Probe, force reaction at the fixed support 2. At the fixed support 3. So I have created 3 force reactions. Right click, insert, beam tool. I'll go to solution, solve. This is the directional deformation of the entire body along the x-axis. This is the deformation along the y-axis. Next is the deformation only at this node 1. Its value is 0.004142 along the x-axis. And along the y-axis, the value is minus 0.015856. The force reaction has been calculated at node 2, 3 and 4. And the direct stress is also given for each element. You can click on max min to get the maximum and minimum value. You can just read the values from here. The value of max is on this beam. The value is 3.964 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. On this second one, 1 to 3, you can see on the truss element. To see, you can just click on probe over here. You'll get the value on this element. And on this element also, you can get the value. It is minus 1.0356 into 10 raised to 5. So this is the minimum value, this is the maximum value, and this is an intermediate value which you find on this element. So the stresses have been found on each element as per the question. For nodal equilibrium, you can just check the force reaction along the y-axis, because the load is applied in y-axis. So we'll see for the y-axis first. The value is 7927.9 Newton. At the first node, it is resisting some part of the 10,000 Newton that has been applied at node 1. So node 2 is showing 7927.9. Node 3 is showing the value as 2070.9. And node 4 is showing the value as 1.1598. The summation of the forces along the y-axis for node 2, 3 and 4 is approximately 9999, which is very close to 10,000. Which means my solution is correct. Likewise, you can also check for the x-axis. The value is, the summation of 2 and 3 is equal and opposite to the value of force along the x-axis for the fourth node. So this is how you can check the values. So we have to determine the displacement at the nodes, which has been done. I have determined the stresses in each bar. Also, I have verified the nodal equilibrium at node 1. So this is how the problem of truss analysis of this type has to be solved. I hope you have understood the numerical. If you have any doubts or you want me to solve any question, definitely let me know in the comment section. I'll solve the question and I'll post it in my channel. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon for latest updates of my videos. I'll see you in the next session with another numerical. Thank you.